Hello everyone, this is Blackfoot Ferret. If you're a Steven Universe fan, you've probably heard about the two new episodes, Can't Go Back and A Single Pale Rose, and that they have caused quite a huge controversy. Although most SU3 channels have already revealed it, the massive spoiler warning is in full effect. This is a Pacific Rim Kaiju class spoiler, the kind that says, "Hello robot, I'm going to eat your gawking face." What happened was so big and transformative to the series that the official Steven Universe Twitter account published public video links so anyone could immediately watch them for free. I've included links to this Twitter post in the text box below. So if you haven't already seen Can't Go Back and A Single Pale Rose, please stop this video and watch them before someone spoils the surprise for you. So with the spoiler warning done, it's time to deal with a bombshell. In Can't Go Back, Steven finds Lapis on the moon, and discovers her using an observation orb to spy on the Crystal Gems who she wants to return to, but is afraid to join in case the Diamond's return. After a new song and some heartwarming catching up, Steven has a sudden dream of Blue Diamond talking to Pink, and then a shadow of Pearl creeping up behind Pink with Rose's sword in a menacing manner. In A Single Pale Rose, Steven asks Pearl about this dream, only to find something prevents her from talking about it. Instead, Pearl sends Steven inside her gem to find her cell phone, talking to several different versions of her in the process, until he reaches the memory of the day Rose supposedly shattered Pink. Only to find that not only didn't Rose shatter Pink, but Rose actually was Pink Diamond. That Pink, who Steven had always been taught was the enemy, was actually his mother. That one of the diamonds is part of his own fusion, explaining his amazing powers. This story is of special importance to me, because 15 months ago, I made a video called Rose Quartz Ate Pink Diamond, a theory with a twist ending where Pink actually gifted her powers to Rose to found the Crystal Gems. I clarified and expanded this idea even more in the follow-up video 2 months ago. And a week ago in my leak reaction video, Don't Give Up, where I argued that spoilers or not, there was still a lot left to discover in the show. And now, over a year after the original theory, some, but not all, of the points I made long ago turned out to be true. Steven does have the power of Pink Diamond. Pink Diamond supported the Crystal Gems. Many theorists have claimed Rose Quartz was Pink Diamond over the years, and now what once seemed like a crazy theory is finally getting its time in the sun. And I did a lot of groundwork to show why this was a viable theory. I should be happy. I should be over the moon! But it feels hollow, because with this news it seems like the fandom is having a second crisis in so many weeks. Many theorists reacted to the reveal with horror. For those who followed the show for years, theory confirmations are much more often a time for broken dreams than celebration. Only more so when a radical, seemingly improbable theory is confirmed. Shock and disbelief ruled the day. Worse still, it began to turn into despair and anger. People lashed out at Pink, calling her a horrible character, worse even than the other diamonds and their campaign to destroy all organic life. And a gathering of YouTube SU theorists held shortly after the reveal seemed to agree that Steven being Pink was a terrible creative decision that seemed to go nowhere, and might even spell the doom of the show. So, I feel the first thing I should do is calm some fears and put out some fires. The show is in perfect health. The Crooniverse revealed in a recent tweet that Steven being Pink Diamond was one of the very first plot details they agreed on, even before production began. All the amazing stories we've enjoyed for years have been leading up to this point. And considering how much we've loved Steven Universe so far, I doubt they would insist on this plot point unless they had big plans in mind. Just because we're finally getting answers about Pink doesn't mean the show is over. There are many stories in Steven Universe. The Mysterious Lapis, White Diamond, the interstellar war Pink Diamond was a refugee from according to the Cookie Cat song, hints of the gems fighting an enemy in space long before Earth was even colonized. In my blog, Don't Give Up, I raised a ton of questions we still don't know about the show, and the possibility that there might be a huge secret hidden in Beach City, hinted at in all the townie episodes. And the chance that Onion Gang and Rock Naldo, two episodes frequently dismissed by the fandom, might be the keys to understanding this secret. Steven Universe loves to challenge people's assumptions, and make them see the world in different ways. We thought Steven's guardians were the only uncorrupted gems left on Earth, but Amethyst wasn't protected by Rose's shield, yet escaped corruption. If Amethyst could survive the song, perhaps other gems did also. We thought that the only way a gem could have a child was to pass on their gem, like Rose did with Steven. Yet the very first enemies the Crystal Gems fight in Gemglow are Centipedal's gemless children, made from the very same light that animates the gems. The world of Steven is vast and weird, and we're only just starting to explore the galaxy. It's naive of us to think that we've seen more than the tip of the iceberg. There's a reason why Einstein and Winston, revered, weird scientists, Can't say enough good things about imagination. It's our ability to visualize how things might be different that leads to our greatest breakthroughs. It's always dangerous to jump to conclusions, especially in a clever show like SU that deliberately writes against expectations. And those you thought were your enemies could turn out to be your greatest friends or even family. Many people are saying that Pink Diamond was a terrible person, and perhaps she did make her own share of impulsive mistakes. But you also have to put yourself in her shoes and think why she did what she did. We learn a lot from the ghostly memory and Can't Go Back. Pink, who wanted a colony so badly, is being chastised by Blue because now she's changed her mind and wants to leave it. The other diamonds look down on Pink as if she's a child, with Blue not even allowing Pink to speak. Blue tells Pink that the colony will be completed, and all Pink has to do is smile and wave and do nothing. But Blue is misreading something important. Blue thinks Pink hasn't destroyed the human cities because Pink is weak and incompetent, that Pink isn't capable of such planning. But the zoo shows us that Pink values human life. Blue never considers that Pink hasn't destroyed the human cities because Pink doesn't want to. That Pink is starting to listen to the crystal gems. And rather than do nothing and allow the Earth to be destroyed, Pink did something and saved the Earth. As for being incompetent, Pink may have made a breakthrough in creating gems without destroying a world. Bismuth says Rose Quartz was another quartz soldier made right here in the dirt. And we see Pink Diamond crush some dirt into very convincing pink gem shards. Perhaps this was the reason the Rose Kindergarten was never found. Making rose gems only used up a little bit of soil instead of destroying a world. It does seem like Pink had selfish motivations for manipulating Pearl and the other gems to escape her responsibilities as a diamond. Yet, if Pink's motives were purely selfish, why would she end her own existence by giving her gem to Steven? This was not a spur-of-the-moment decision, but something she had to think about for thousands of years. Rose/Pink was with many human men, but deliberately choosing Greg to be Steven's father wasn't an accident. And if Pink had ideas of how the Great Diamond Authority could do things better, but the other diamonds wouldn't listen to her, then she would have to prove her ideas worked in the field in a manner the other diamonds could not ignore. It's tempting to assume that Rose Quartz never actually existed after watching a single pale rose. That rose was always an alter ego of Pink. But this is one of those dangerous assumptions again. And there are still unanswered questions that hint the story could still be more complex than we know. Titan Pink from Gemcation still looms in my mind. Even accepting the gem can rotate their gemstone during a transformation, we still haven't seen any gem capable of transforming their material core. Titan Pink has a traditional four-sided diamond that can't be the result of gem rotation. And her form is like a terrifying nightmare, nothing at all like the circle-shoed elf we see in Jungle Moon in Pale Rose. Garnet's flashback in Your Mother and Mine also describes Pink as a giant. And while that was famously inaccurate, the Gemcation scene was witnessed by Pearl, Bismuth, and two other crystal gems, making it much harder to dismiss. And then there's Steven's ability to possess other creatures, a power we know now comes from Pink Diamond. Could Pink have been warped into a titan by the other diamonds trying to fix her, quote-unquote, then tried to restore herself to her original form by possessing Rose and then shattering her Frankenstein gem in the hopes that she or Steven could fix it? Roundtable Stardust commenter Red Soup had a point when she mentioned Pink Diamond was larger than Rose Quartz, and staying permanently size-shifted down to a smaller form for thousands of years should be impossible. Then there's an icon similar to Rose's shield behind the door to Pink Diamond's ship, opposite another version of the one gem at the top of the door. Yet this symbol is less ornate and has a dark pink triangle at the center instead of Rose's blazing white sigil, almost as if one icon was the opposite of the other. So for the moment, I'm holding out hope that we haven't seen all of Pink Diamond's story, and that Rose Quartz actually was a real person that Pink went on to possess. But I may just be delaying the inevitable. I must accept that the beautiful headcanon I created in the follow-up video, an Avengers-level epic event where Steven, Lars, Pink, and the Crystal Gems win the respect of the Diamonds by helping defend Homeworld from the ultimate evil in the universe, to the blazing chords of sweet metalized Undertale music, is most likely just a colorful, ethereal flight of fancy, doomed to blow away in the wind one day as the show takes a completely different direction. The Critiverse released the Anatomy of a Steven Universe Fan recently, and believe me when I say I feel the heartbreak and existential crisis as much as anyone. But if nothing else, I hope sharing my imagination with you all shows that there are still directions the show can take. That even after seemingly hitting a wall with Steven being Pink Diamond, the story isn't over. And if I can come up with annoying Jerry from Undertale being the ultimate evil in the universe, then just imagine what Rebecca and the Cooniverse can come up with. Steven Universe isn't over. It's only just beginning to shine. Thank you all for listening to my blog. And speaking of colorful alternate universes, you might want to check out the Rebel Gems project on YouTube. I talked to these folks on Google Hangouts recently, and they seem like nice people. Hardcore Steven Universe fans who are making a thing. Good night, everyone.